Om Shri Ganeshaya Namaha, Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Of late, with a lot of people working from home and the family spending time together, practically 24 hours a day, being at home can be really conflicting, can create friction, arguments, disharmony in the family, because we're all used to having a certain lifestyle, having our own space and doing our work, and suddenly when we have to spend the 24 hours together, it kind of creates a lot of friction. I have been getting calls of late requesting for solutions that can be done to keep the peace and harmony going at home, maintain the level of tranquility. What are the negativity or the friction is what of late people are asking me. Well, the solution is very, very simple. Take some crystal salt, okay, and a handful of it maybe in a small bowl, glass bowl or a porcelain or a crystal bowl. Keep it in the southwest corner of the house. You start this on a Wednesday, okay, and then the same Saturday you dispose that. This is the first time what you're doing. You can just flush it in your kitchen sink, okay, or wash basin. Don't use it, use your hand as much as possible. Avoid directly touching it because it would have absorbed negativity. Just directly pour it into the sink and just flush it, and then you can wash the container and then refill again on a Saturday, same day. Immediately you refill again and keep it in the southwest corner of the house, and from then on you do it every Saturday. But you start off on a Wednesday, clear that energy on Saturday, and from Saturday onwards, every Saturday you change the salt, and every time you flush it. This is what you need to do. It's very, very effective in absorbing the negativity of the house. See, basically, this practice is something that you should do even otherwise. Whether there's lockdown or no lockdown, if you follow this particular practice, how it's going to help you is that whenever you go out and come inside, especially nowadays, people are living more in apartments. It so happens that there is no provision to wash your feet and then enter the house. So a lot of negativity which you pick up from outside, it enters your being through your legs, your feet. And then when you enter the house without washing your feet, what happens is that you're just spreading the negativity within the house itself. So always remember that as soon as you enter the house, whether you live in an apartment or an independent house, first thing is head to the bathroom, wash your feet, wash your ankle. It should be completely washed in water. And then your hands, rinse your mouth, and then you do your other activities. Not only from hygiene point of view, from energy level point of view also. Second thing is that you do this particular thing what I told you. Always maintain that salt. So always whatever negativity is there, which you are carrying in your aura, from because of you rubbing shoulders with others. I don't mean in the physical sense alone, but generally like interaction and all that. So even that gets cleansed. And if you feel one particular person is acting weird or funny, something like, you know, very adamant and fussy and suddenly cranky behavior, you're not expecting somebody to behave in a certain way and they are behaving like that, then the same, what I mean to say is the same crystal salt, you can keep it in your left hand and just do it around the head of the person 3 times anti-clockwise, and then just dispose it again in the sink and wash your hands and feet, whoever is doing this for the other person. This is also very, very effective. Simple home remedies which your grandmother would have followed, which your parents would have done for you, you should just continue with that. It will really help you and keep your energy levels intact without disturbing it, without any negativity or any disturbance from external agencies or different energies that you pick up sometimes. And another thing that you could do to enhance the harmony. See, one thing is you clear the negativity. Second thing is to bring in some kind of harmony within the relationships that you have, like parents and children, being harmonious, more loving. So there is something called madhuratva, which is sometimes missing in families. Some sweetness in the relationship, some love, some sharing, some caring. You know, if you feel that all this is missing in the house, then what you should do is, again, a very, very simple home remedy. You get honey, right? As much as possible, pure honey. You just offer that to Lord Krishna as Naivedya. I'm not saying do elaborate rituals for Naivedya, draw mandala. I'm not telling you to do anything like that. See, he is the embodiment of Krishna, is the embodiment of Madhuratva. So how do you request him or pray to him? how do you pray to him to get some kind of sweetness in your life is through offering of honey. So just one small teaspoon or even lesser than a teaspoon of honey, you just offer it to Krishna. If you have Krishna's photo at home, if you don't have photo, don't worry, it's still fine. Mentally, heartily, just tell yourself you're offering it to Krishna. Just in a small spoon, you just say, okay Krishna, this is for you, please, your embodiment of love, your embodiment of sweetness in all kinds of relationships, you've been so perfect, so please bring some madhuratva or some sweetness into my life, in all my relationships. Let us nurture each other, let us have harmony, let us have the attitude of sharing and caring. Then you see, you know, things will change. Now people often ask me, how many days do I need to do, how often do I need to do? See, it's again up to you. See, there is no prescribed, you know, there is no prescription like, okay, these many weeks only, like that. See, make it a way of life. And when things stabilize and you feel, okay, now things are okay, maybe you can stop for some time and see how long it sustains. And again, if it continues to be bad or if it goes down again, then you can start this again. If it maintains well and things are good, fine. Just continue to have gratitude. And that honey, when you offer it mentally, after that you take it as prasad. So just little bit. It's just enough to lick. Just that much. So, you know, that can really help and go a long way in your family. All of you will be very, develop those sweet qualities. And, you know, instead of saying like, you know, I say something to my wife, she goes exactly, she does opposite. Even I have people complaining when they say that, you know, my wife asks me today, what do I make for breakfast? Shall I make dosa or idli? And if I tell her you make dosa, she makes idli. And she's the one who will ask me. And then she is the one who doesn't follow. These kind of small things are also affecting people these days. So it's become that bad that, you know, you get onto each other's nerves, and children don't listen to parents, and parents find children irritating, and children find parents irritating, and it's never ending. So, you know, it's time to bring in some sweetness, eliminate something negative from the house, and then you see, whether there is lockdown or no lockdown, whether you spend 8 hours a day or 1 hour a day, it will be a very a beautiful moment that you spend. It will take time. These are all small remedies, but effective remedies. But they take time, but they have their own charm. It really helps. Try it out, and then let me know your feedback for both the salt part as well as the honey part. Thank you. Namaste.